In this video, I will show how to troubleshoot computers and laptops that are not turning on, how to test the different components, and find where the issue lies and how to fix it.
But nothing happened. So the first thing that you want to check is that the computer is connected to the power grid. How you do that? You go to the back of the computer. In this case, you can see that the cable was not connected all the way. It's supposed to be very, very deep inside the inlet. After that, you can check again to see if the computers will turn on. Okay, let's say that didn't help. So if you noticed on this computer, on the rear side, there is a button that can be mistakenly go to the off function and it won't let the computer to turn on. So you need to turn it on like so, and then you can try again. You can now see that lights are turning on. So this is a good sign, and it might be that the problem has been solved. But in many cases, something else can happen. So sometimes your power cord is connected to a power splitter with a button, and sometimes by accident this button can be shut down, and if the light is off, that means that maybe it's on the off function, so you need to turn it on like so, and then try to turn on your computer. If that didn't help, you need to check that you have power in the inlet itself. And there's, I will teach two ways to do that. So the more advanced way is to see with a tester screwdriver, meter actually, okay, so this is it. So this is the meter. It's got like a bulb inside, and it will turn on if there is power. I don't know if you can see it. Okay, so there is light. So that means that the outlet is giving power. But if you don't have this advanced screwdriver, you can check with another device that you know for sure that it's working, this light. Okay, so I put it in the other outlet and I test to see that there is electricity. So now that I know that all the outlets are giving power, and I checked that the power cord is connected, it's time to go and make more advanced checking. So a good way to start before you disassemble the computer is to do a power discharge. and I will show what this means. To make a power discharge, you need to disconnect this power cord like this and press and hold the power button for about a half a minute. That makes all the electricity that is on the capacitor on the motherboard to be discharged, and this can make the computer start again. After you do this, you connect the power cord again. I'm checking everything is okay. You can do this also with laptops. So to do this with a laptop, if it's possible on your laptop to disconnect the battery, you should disconnect it. Like so, and then you need to press the power button for a really long time, like half a minute, and this will discharge the electricity from the PSU, which is the power supply, and this can cause the computer to start working again. After half a minute, you leave the button. You connect the battery if you disassemble it, and then try to turn on the computer again. So, very good. Now, let's go back to the desktop computer. Some manufacturers that have known issue with power discharge with the power supplies that they made a dedicated button that will discharge the power. Okay, so sometimes you can unscrew these bolts with your hand, and sometimes you will need usually a Phillips screwdriver. And then you can slide this panel off and you can look at the inside of your computer. So our suspect, there is a problem with the PSU, which is the power supply. The other main components here, I will go roughly, this is the hard drive with all the data. This, under this fan, lies the CPU, and everything is connected to the motherboard, which is the electricity component that make everything, all the parts talk with each other. So, in order to check if there is a problem with the PSU, we need to disconnect it from the motherboard. I will show you how. This part is connecting the PSU to the motherboard, and this also. So we are going to disconnect these two components. Sometimes there is a piece of plastic here that you need to click this in order that it will open and let you pull it out. And the other one also got this little notch that holding it in place. So after you disconnect it, you need to short some wires. In order to turn on your PSU outside of the computer, we disconnected the two plastic attachments, connectors from the motherboard, a regular paperclip, and I'm bending it so I will have. Okay, so what you need to do after you make this, you need to find the green and black pins and make a short by connecting them like this. And immediately you can see that the power supply turn on, and it will stay on like this until I will remove the pins again. So the power supply in this case is working great. Also, there is a possibility, but very unlikely, that there is a problem with the power button itself. And if I shortcut two of these pins, the ones that said power, not every time this will be mentioned on the board, like in this case, I don't see. I think it's these two. I will try
between
to shortcut
these
them.
these two pins, and as you can see, the computer start working. So it was a problem with the power button. Let's continue.
Sometimes your computer will turn on, but your display will remain black. And this can happen because of a bad component of the RAM memory. In this case, you need to pull it out, try to spray some compressed air, or just some air with your mouth even to clean socket. Clean also the component memory itself. And if that doesn't help, you can also transfer the socket to another socket. And you need to hear the click sound back in place. So sometimes your computer will turn on, but your screen will remain black. Like this. Since you know that the monitor or screen is getting power, so the problem is something else. The first thing that you need to check is that you connected the signal cable to the computer. In this computer, there are two options for monitor signal cable. In some cases, you will have more options, or other options like HDMI or DisplayPort. But this is a little bit old computer and it's got only the VGA port or the DVI port. So I'm gonna make sure that the cable is inserted all the way and if it's possible to close these screws a little bit. If you checked and then check again, the cable is still connected firmly from the side of the computer and from the side of the monitor. Another common problem, especially if you're getting the check signal cable and the computer is on, is that you are not in the correct source. So how do you change it? If you got a remote, you can do it with the remote, but if not, you go to the input button and then you select the correct the correct input for your computer, for example VGA, and then you can see that everything is working okay. So make sure that whatever your computer signal coming out from, the TV or the monitor is adjusted to the correct input. So I hope this guide will help a lot of people fix their own computer at home and continue work. If you like this video, I will appreciate if you subscribe. Thank you.